Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and they show us their latest products and services. Today, I'm joined by Brian Anderson. He's with Cato Networks. Welcome to the show, Brian.
Thank you for having me.
Tell me a little bit about Cato Networks. Who are you? What do you guys do?
Cato Networks is a SASE provider. So it's Secure Access Service Edge. And it's basically networking and security converged into a single cloud native platform.
Right. And so what are you here to show us today?
Today we're going to be showing you a new capability that we're making available next month to our customers, digital experience monitoring, or Cato DEM.
Mm-hmm. And who is this? Is this designed for security people? Is it designed for networking people?
So kind the platform caters to security and networking, yeah. But digital experience monitoring caters to IT operations folks. So extending past the capability of traditional SASE, which is networking and security, into more of an IT operations kind of a use case.
Yeah, and what's the big problem that you're trying to solve? Like, why should viewers care about what this digital experience monitoring thing is?
Well, with SASE in general, we have a cloud native platform that combines security and networking into mm-hmm. one platform, and then identifying where problems are throughout the environment. If there's an experience issue, if someone's unable to access a business critical application, how do we get down to the root of that cause? What does that cost to a company? And so that's really what this is honing in on. It's a byproduct of us having visibility throughout an entire environment, and then giving that capability of identifying those issues to IT support and staff.
Now, if a company did not have this product, what would they be doing? Would they have like a separate security team using one platform and a separate networking team using a second one, what would they be doing if they didn't have this?
Yeah, so typically, historically, there's a variety of point solutions that address individual particular issues. And so this is, the SASE market is consolidating that or converging that into one platform, simplifying everything down to a single dashboard, down to a single set of events, down to a single set of policies. That's kind of the charter of what Cato is looking to solve. And this is just one more additional feature or capability that's built into that platform.
All right, so let's jump into the demo and show me some of the cool features.
Sure, absolutely.
Do you guys call it just Cato Networks DEM?
Cato DEM.
Cato
is kind
DEM.
Of the new
okay.
term for it, yeah.
Right, okay.
So what we're looking at here is the CMA, or Cato Management Application, that is the front end to the Cato SASE cloud platform. And on this screen, we see a topology of all of the different data centers and branch locations and users that are connected to the network.
Okay.
Up at the top here, I've got some navigation here that's interesting. Again, we said that this platform caters to networking and security. Under the network tab, I could define all of my subnets, my routing, my network rules. Under the access, I can define who can access the platform and how they can connect.
Okay.
Under security, I can create firewall rules for things like internet access or WAN connectivity, wide area network, connecting branch locations and data centers. And then I have also maybe LAN connectivity for inter-branch networking that I can make rules for there as well.
Okay.
We have assets that talk to integrations and then administration for general system settings.
All right.
But under monitoring on the left side here, what's important to note is we have dashboards that cater to each one of these personas that may jump into the dashboard that needs information. So in here, here's a networking dashboard. If I look at the last month worth of data, I can see if I have any congestion on my network, if I have any links that are down, if I have any packets that are being dropped, right? So then I jump up maybe to a security use case where I want to see what kind of threats and attacks that I have coming into my environment and get visibility from that perspective. Because of the breadth of data and visibility that we have, we also have application analytics. Right, so give you visibility into who is accessing what application across your entire environment. And this is just another way to converge or consolidate these into a single platform here. And waiting for connectivity here for this to come back here. But today we're going to be looking at digital experience monitoring.
Okay.
And so in digital experience monitoring, really there's three use cases that we'd like to share. One is going to be real-time user monitoring. The second one is going to be cloud application and network optimization. And the third piece is troubleshooting and triage, or investigation and triage. So in the first use case here, what I'm looking at is in the experience monitoring screen, an overview and average of all the connectivity that I have across my sites, my users, my hosts, and my applications, right? So if I go back and let's say that I'm an IT operations staff member and I get a call about somebody not able to access a particular application, what I can do is go down into the user section and maybe filter for a particular user. And I'm going to filter for Brian Anderson in this case, right? And I see, sure enough, that there was a degradation in performance during a certain window of time.
Okay.
And now what I can do is dig into this and say, okay, what happened during this window of time, and let's see and get a little bit more information. So I had a poor connection. When I click on Brian Anderson's user, And I scroll down here. First of all, I get some attributes here about the last time I connected. This is my ISP. Here's the host I'm connected from. But now I have this hop by hop breakdown of analysis of each step from the host all the way to the application. And we have the Wi-Fi connection details. We have the LAN gateway, which is the box that connects to the internet. We have the quality of internet connection that you have. And then we have the tunnel, which is what we call the overlay or the encrypted tunnel that connects to our platform. And then at last, we have the application itself. Now for this window of time, it looks like we have some resource issues on this host. We've got 85% plus memory consumption trying to access 20 something applications at the same time. But then we also see that there's an internet connection issue as well, right? So if we jump into the internet connection issue, I'm gonna see that there is some distance between this. Looks like there's 900 plus millisecond delay. And just for context, in our platform globally, we have an average connection time or round trip time for under 20 milliseconds. Mm-hmm. So 900 milliseconds is significant. And so this poor internet connection led to obviously a bad tunnel and obviously poor connection to these applications. And so in addition to that, with the host being under-resourced, an IT service member can then come in and get right to the root of the problem and understand why somebody may be experiencing an issue.
And in a case like this, could it have been something that was historical too? Like it happens every, between 9 and 10 a.m. and, and you go back weeks and discover that, and then maybe
that's exactly right.
Someone who unplugged something at some point.
That's exactly right.
Like some cleaner unplugged the thing and put in.
Right. Yeah. So in the IT space, there's a concept of time to innocence and time to resolution. Because people always want to blame the security product on the issue, or they maybe don't know where the issue is. And so the IT staff is burdened with trying to find where that issue is, getting down to the root of it, and then trying to resolve that. And that's a real cost. That time and that resource and the time it takes to resolve a case is a real cost to big organizations.
Okay. You got some other stuff that you're going to show?
Sure. Yep. So this is the real-time user monitoring use case.
Okay.
The second use case is around cloud application and network optimization. So what I've done is I've navigated over to the Stories workbench here. And the Stories workbench, let me just increase the time here for the amount of data that we're looking at. A story is an anomaly. We see a lot of data and we have models that run on top of that data to say, hey, this is an actionable event. You should look at something that changed in this environment.
Okay.
And if I filter here, there's a lot of security anomalies and other types of anomalies that we have. But I'm specifically going to be looking for an experience anomaly. So let's see what we can find under the experience anomaly filter here. I've got a lot of events that have popped up here and I could organize them by maybe my sources. So these are categorized by site. If I'm an IT professional, maybe I come back from PTO, I want to look at what happened last week. I see I've got two critical issues and then several other non-critical issues that are tied to a certain location. When I click on this, it's going to give me an indication that there was an application that had a performance problem. In the same way that we saw when I looked at a user, I can then dig into this particular time frame, and I can look again at this hop by hop here. And so the scenario here is that we have an application that stopped performing well, and I can see that these are neutral because these are not necessarily involved in the story that's being produced. We have synthetic probes that go from our app, from our infrastructure down to the application, and what we've identified is that that application stopped responding quickly, so we could say, hey, something happened here. Now, the reason we're bringing this up is that Cato owns the network and we can optimize that network. So in this case, what we can do is if it's a cloud application that's either a SaaS application or it's hosted in some public cloud, maybe they're hosted in Virginia and somebody's trying to connect from Australia. What we can do is egress or have that traffic come out of our infrastructure in Virginia directly close to where the origin server is. And we can also implement something called the QoS rule, quality of service rule. We prioritize maybe Office or 365 traffic over things like YouTube or Facebook or Instagram that don't have as much priority. So for the bandwidth that we have under high utilization, we could prioritize that traffic, and that's how we can optimize that end to end.
Yeah, okay. It sounds fairly complicated to kind of get all through a lot of this. So is it easy to deploy, or do you have to be a customer of Cato Networks already, or is it something that customers can look without having, working with you guys initially?
So to answer the first question, it's very, very easy to connect to us. We have a variety of ways to connect to any of your branch locations or data centers, and users can connect to the same network from their workstations.
Right.
And as soon as you connect to it, you're on the global backbone. You have access to everything there. And this is something that's available to all Cato customers. So if you're a Cato customer, digital experience monitoring or Cato DEM can be enabled on your account. You get this next level of visibility. But the network rules and all the other capabilities are already a part of the platform. This is something that will just help you inform how to optimize that more efficiently.
So you got one more thing that you want to show, right?
Sure. We just looked at the cloud application network optimization. And the third use case that we have to share is around investigation and response. Now, what I've done is I've navigated over to the monitoring events tab here. And under events, we have access to every single event, every network flow, everything that's traversed our backbone. And so I can go through and filter for, again, all kinds of security, all kinds of network events. Specifically, what we're looking for today, though, is accessing user data. So in this case, maybe somebody calls in and they say, I wasn't able to access my application. I was blocked for some reason. Either it's a performance problem or I was not able to get to that. So we do give you the ability to filter for these events down here, but I can also do this in something that's like normal language. So I can say, show me, risky events.
Oh. Yeah.
This week, for example, and I can ask this anything and it'll give me back those events. But maybe what I want to do instead of showing me risky events, I want to show Brian Anderson, and we have user display name, and I want to see the domain, and I'll say with domain and action, right? And the action is what the rule is, whether or not I got blocked on that, right? So then I could see, okay, now I have Brian Anderson's traffic. This is my user that's logged in, and I see that there were some monitor events. Let's go ahead and say if
I can actually. This is all powered by AI, by the way?
Absolutely.
This is the AI portion of
exactly,
our show.
Exactly, yeah. Absolutely.
Okay.
So we have AI models, and this is that.
That's really cool.
That front end, yeah. So we can ask it anything because there's so much data here.
Yeah.
And what I see that's interesting about this is I do see an office. Brian Anderson was trying to access Office 365. I see the application. Now, this is a raw event, but we have so many rich attributes. It's an enriched event that I can see the direction of the traffic. I could see the domain, the egress IP address, the host IP, and I could also see the rule that was triggered. In this case, the rule triggered here says restricted geo access for SaaS applications. And maybe it's a corporate policy that I can't log in from, in this case, Auckland, to try to access this application. So this is a good indicator of getting to the root of the issue. I could now see at the host level if this user had an issue, at the network level for anomalous kind of things, and even at the raw event level, what actually happened with this raw event here. So I can go and get right to the root of the issue. And this really speaks to investigation and response.
Yeah, it feels like this would save companies a lot of time trying to investigate a lot of the different problems that they have on the networks and on the security side, right?
That's exactly right. So we provide a world-class security, enterprise-grade security solution on top of our network that handles all of your threats and all of your attacks. And then we give you, of course, a global, resilient, available network, 5.9 availability across any region that you would need to be in with, again, 20 millisecond connectivity time. And now insights on top of that to be able to get to the bottom of why people would experience an issue over their network.
Right. Are you offering a free trial of the new digital experience?
Absolutely.
Digital experience.
Yeah, digital experience monitoring.
Monitoring, okay.
That's right, DEM.
And you guys have a free trial, right?
Absolutely.
This? Yeah. So where can people go for more information? Because there's a lot of features here that people should explore.
You can go to catonetworks.com and you can sign up for a demo and sign up for a trial.
All right. Brian Anderson, again, thanks for being on the show.
Hey, thank you very much.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.